In the most recent versions of Excel, similar to the slicer, there actually is a new option called Insert Timeline. When you click Insert Timeline, you'll see it identifies anything that's got some sort of a date or time characteristic, and those are the options you can choose. So in this case, we've got an item called date. I'm going to click on date and say OK. And it brings this up. Now what this is a timeline representation of the data that's here. And if I want to quickly go and just see all the January data, I can click there. And this is now only showing January 2006. If I do February, March, you'll see the little drag lines, so we can actually highlight them all and it shows it all. Notice as well that this is currently showing in months, but I could also say rather showed in years or quarters, or we can get down to days, in which case it's down to almost every single day, and notice it goes through all the various months. So for example, I want to see what happened on that day there. This information is shown. Again, if we want to see all the data again, we click there and it's all shown. Similar to slices, when you click on it, there's a new option here called Options. And again, you've got various things you can do. What do you want to see? Controlling the height and width. Looking at the various aspects. Perhaps you don't like the color schemes. And then again, you have the report connections, which allows you to control what this period controls. So if I switch all of those on and I say OK, then my other pivot tables are now linked to it. So let's go back to months and I'm going to say I only want to see March. So here we only see March, but then notice all these numbers tie in. So this timeline graphic is controlling all my pivots in this spreadsheet.